Good morning, students. Yesterday we discussed about the separation of insoluble solids from a liquid. In that, this method we discussed, that is the sedimentation and decantation. We learn this with practical. Okay, do you understand the first method, how to separate the insoluble substances from a liquid? Okay, now second method is there, that is the filtration. Okay, which method is there? Second, filtration. See, this activity you done in 4th, 5th standard also, how to do the filtration. But today again we will perform the practical, as well as what is filtration and where this method is used. See, filtration, this method is used mostly whenever the insoluble substances are present in a water. Okay, do you observe in, means see, daily or whenever the mother is preparing tea, okay, with tea strainer she separates the tea powder, because the tea powder is insoluble in water. But sugar, she is able to separate that? No. Why? Because the sugar is soluble in water. Okay, so in daily so many activities we are using the filtration method. See, a filter, do you know the filter? What is the use of the filter? Okay, to get the pure water. The same purpose this filtration method is used whenever the insoluble particles are dissolved in water. To separate that particles, we are using this filtration method. Okay, so now we will perform one activity, and this activity it is given in your textbook. After this activity, what you do, just write the definition of filtration in your chemistry notebook, as well as see the diagram is given, filtration, that diagram also you have to draw. Okay, so now let's perform the activity. See here, in this petri dish what is present? It is a mud, okay, or means it is a soil, in that so many stones and so many things are available. Okay, now this soil we will add in this water. See here, this soil will add in this water. See, okay, just stir it, then what will happen? See here, the heavier particles, see, in sedimentation and decantation in this we learn, the heavier particles settle downside, okay, and the lighter particles, they will float on this water. See, now the heavier particles means stones and all, that is settled down, and the lighter particles are there, that is, see here, they are float on water. Now what, this you keep aside for some time. Okay, now what, how to filter this? For this process we need this filter paper. See, this is one filter paper. Okay, how to fold, that also process is given in your textbook. Just take this filter paper and fold it this way. Okay, and then again fold. See, and then you prepare this way cone. Okay, and then this filter paper you have to keep here and add this water. See here, whatever the insoluble particles, those are present here with this sand and all, it will be collect on this filter paper, and the filter water we will get here. Are you able to see this? See this water and this water, what is the difference in this bowl? Okay, this is a clear water. How we get this clear water? Because of this filtration process. Okay, now see, whatever the collected in this beaker, this is known as a filtrate. Okay, after the filtration you will get this clear water, that is known as a filtrate. And see here, on this filter paper here, the this is remaining, means what, sand and soil is present here, that is known as a residue. Okay, just think again, see, this is the residue and this is known as a filtrate. Okay, the solution which one we are getting here after the filtration, that is known as a filtrate, and the insoluble particles remain on this filter paper, that is known as a residue. Okay, this activity is given in your textbook. When you will come back in the school, this all activity you all have to perform in our lab. Okay, do you understand the filtration process? Now the next process we will continue further.